Asian. I only know Tari Makashiri. That's it. I'm so sorry. So we're going to be talking about a new technology that, as it says here, this is the only technology that reduces visceral fat. What's visceral fat is the fat under the muscle, the fat that wraps around our vital organs that is very, very dangerous. So this is the only technology that can reduce that type of fat and give you a healthy body, the way the gym gives you a healthy body. But it takes so much effort and so much time in the gym, where this one is effortless, and it does a similar effect in 1 hour of what you would have in the gym for 1 month. So 1 hour of this device, the Iron Magnum, is worth 1 month in the gym. 12 times in the Iron Magnum is worth a year in the gym. So it's faster and it's effortless. So that is the advantage of it.
Okay. Jadi hari ini kita akan meluncurkan Iron Magnum. Iron Magnum itu adalah merupakan suatu alat yang revolusioner, yang dimana alat ini tujuannya adalah merupakan suatu teknologi utama untuk mengatasi visceral fat. Dimana visceral fat itu adalah suatu visceral fat yang berada di bawah muscle yang sangat berbahaya. Jadi biasanya kalau kita mau melakukan pembakaran lemak di visceral fat, kita harus melakukan olahraga yang effortnya cukup besar. Jadi dan juga memakan waktu. Dan sedangkan kalau dengan menggunakan alat ini, ibaratnya sama seperti kita pergi ke gym dengan satu kali treatment, itu hasilnya sama seperti kita satu bulan di gym. Dan dengan 12 kali treatment, itu sama halnya dengan kita gym 1 tahun. Seperti itu.
Okay.
Jadi it's hasilnya cool. Sangat cepat dan safe.
Okay, so what does it do? Like we said, one treatment is 1 month in the gym. 10 treatments are like 10 months in the gym. We already went through that.
Ya, jadi seperti tadi katakan, satu treatment sama dengan 1 bulan, 10 treatment sama dengan 10 bulan.
Now, how was it developed? It was originally developed in London University in the UK. It was actually built by the co-inventor of the first pacemaker. It was financed by the Multiple Sclerosis Society, the MS Society, because they were trying to invent something that will replace the signal of the motor nerve that is damaged in multiple sclerosis. Not the motor nerve that is damaged, but it's the central controls in the brain that are damaged. So they paid a lot of money to have this technology being developed. So the idea was that you're going to have somebody with multiple sclerosis on the machine, but the problem is that they would have to be on the machine all day long. So it became rather cumbersome, and eventually this technology started being used with healthy people, because when it's used with healthy people, it's basically just like going to the gym, but without being in the gym. It's effortless exercise at its best.
Yeah. Jadi teknologi Iron Magnum ini diawali oleh University di London. Jadi investor di sana itu latar belakangi alat ini adalah suatu pacemaker ya. Jadi oleh Gerald Pollack ya. Investor ini dia membuat alat ini itu dasarnya karena adanya multiple sclerosis ya. Adanya penyakit multiple sclerosis di mana penyakit ini itu terjadi hambatan pada central motor neuron, ya, central brain. Jadi diharapkan dengan menggunakan alat ini itu bisa menggantikan sebagai pacemaker tersebut, dan akhirnya bisa juga dipergunakan untuk kesehatan. Jadi orang yang memiliki penyakit multiple sclerosis ini pun bisa dilakukan ini setiap hari untuk supaya memberikan sinyal transduksi dari otak ke ototnya. Seperti itu.
Okay, so it's now manufactured in the Business Innovation Center. This is a research center that is funded by the European Community in order to do research in many different projects. And this is one of the projects that basically was funded by the European Community to continue in the research.
Jadi pabriknya ini dibangun dari Europe.